How do I forward my old email address? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Hey, if you're not subscribed to my weekly Confident Computing newsletter, go visit newsletter.askleo.com after this video is over, of course, and sign up today. Every week you'll get tips, tricks, answers, and explanations like this one in your inbox. Here's today's question. One of my inactive email addresses posted on someone's webpage. It's for a different ISP that I use now. Is there a way that if anyone sends mail to that inactive address, the mail would be forwarded to my current email address? Probably not. The problem is, changing email addresses can be a real pain for exactly the scenario that you're outlining. In fact, it's usually worse because usually we've used our email address not just with our friends and family and it's in all their address books, but we also use it for our online services or our bill pay or our banking or any number of different things. Basically, everything that we might be doing online could be tied to that specific email address. If that email address goes away for any particular reason, that gets tricky. Now, I want to talk first about the email address parts. In other words, the email address that you have, what is it made up of? There are two parts to every email address, and they are separated by that at sign in the middle. To the right of the at sign, in other words, the gmail.com or the outlook.com or the yahoo.com, that's the service that is handling your email. The part in front of the at sign, to the left of the at sign, that is the string that identifies your specific email account with that service. Now, what a lot of people don't realize is that that specific email account part, that's completely ignored by every email service in between your sender and the service that hosts your email account. So if I send something to, say, leo@askleo.com, but I send it from Gmail, Gmail doesn't care that it's Leo. Gmail doesn't care anything. Actually, all it cares about is that this email is destined for askleo.com. And it does whatever is appropriate to take that email address and send it on to askleo.com. That may involve intermediary steps. It's not uncommon. And each one of those intermediary steps ignores everything in front of the at sign. The only thing they're paying attention to is the askleo.com so that they can get that message to the mail server associated with askleo.com. It's only when that email arrives at askleo.com that the server says, okay, this is an email that I do. I'm in charge of handling it. Let's see who it's for. It's for Leo, therefore we'll put it in Leo's mailbox. But those two things are very important to understand because when it gets to changing your email address, you're changing something very important. Your old email address. Let's say you've got an old email address of, what did I use in the article? willie1492@someRandomService.com. So what that means is that at someRandomService.com, you have an email account with that email address, willie1492. The idea is that, again, everybody's ignoring the willie1492 part until it gets to someRandomService.com. Now you get a new email address, willie1492@randomisp.com. Again, nobody pays attention to the willie1492 until it reaches randomisp.com. Now, what you would like to do is for email being sent to that old email address to be automatically forwarded to your new email address. That unfortunately implies that that old email address needs to continue to be active in some regard. Now, in the question, you pointed out that that email address is no longer active. I'm going to assume that it just doesn't work. Email sent to it probably bounces. But the bottom line is that for an old email address, like, again, willie1492@someRandomService.com, even though you're not using someRandomService.com anymore as your primary email address, in order for your email to be forwarded, that account still needs to be open. Now, it is certainly possible for a lot of email services for you to do exactly that. You could keep your Gmail address, for example, and automatically forward it to a different Gmail address or a different address completely. Where things get really complicated is the exact scenario that you asked about, your ISP. When you sign up with your ISP, they likely assigned you an email address on their domain. Maybe you have something at comcast.net. If you then eventually change ISPs because you've moved or you found a better deal or whatever, and you no longer have that account with, say, comcast.net, you now have a new account at some other ISP, ziply.com, which is another one out here, then comcast.net is still going to get all of the email that is sent to your comcast.net email address. Maybe they'll allow you to keep the account open. It's rare. Maybe they'll allow you to keep it open and charge you for it. But the bottom line is that if you move out of their service area, it's very likely that they will not let you keep that email address active, and email sent to that email address will start eventually bouncing. There typically is no way to forward or automatically deal with a change of email address, especially if that email address is associated with an ISP. Now, there are two alternatives. One, and I kind of alluded to this, you could, of course, just set up an email address that isn't associated with your ISP. Many people set up Gmail accounts for exactly that reason. That way, no matter where you are, no matter what you do, no matter where you are on the planet for that matter, you can still use that same email address at gmail.com. And to be clear, any of the services will work for this. Outlook.com, Yahoo Mail, any of the other generalized email providers will do just fine. The issue, of course, is, well, great, what happens if my account gets compromised or I lose access or I get locked out? It happens. Trust me, I get a lot of questions about not being able to access these accounts. And the problem, of course, is that for most of the choices people make, Gmail, Outlook, and so forth, there's no customer service. If something goes wrong, you are severely out of luck. My preferred approach is to purchase a domain name. What do I mean by that? Well, remember we were talking about how the part after the at sign is the part that actually controls the email. That's where the email magic happens. If you can own that, if you can own that domain, then you control exactly how email gets managed. I happen to own askleo.com. That means that any email address I have at askleo.com is under my control. It is something that I manage however I choose to manage it. And that's the real key, because you don't have to manage it any one specific way. In reality, today, email sent to leo at askleo.com, I handle it through a Gmail account. I do. I spend all of my day in Gmail when I'm dealing with email. Now, the interesting thing about that is if for some reason Gmail says, nope, we're locking you out, or I get hacked, or something happens to that Gmail account where it no longer works, I can set up a new account, Gmail or elsewhere, and immediately, or I'll just say within 24 hours, continue to process email on my domain, leo@askleo.com, without anybody else being the wiser. It doesn't impact anybody other than the inconvenience that I might go through relatively quickly to change how my email is processed. There are a lot of ways to process email. Using Gmail or using a third party is one. There are others like ProtonMail, which allow you to do it at the domain level. And of course, many of your domain registrars also provide email support for the domains that you have registered for them. The bottom line here, though, is that owning your own domain gives you the most freedom and gives you what I refer to as an email address for life. leo@askleo.com will be mine as long as I choose to own the domain. There's nothing that would get in the way of that. No matter what happens to Gmail, no matter what happens to other email processors, that's my domain for as long as I own it. And that means that that's my email address for life. That's what I suggest you do. If you are in a situation where you find yourself having to change your email address, Maybe you're changing ISPs, maybe you're moving, doing something like that. Think about what email address you wish you had been using. Maybe it's a Gmail account. Maybe it's a free account somewhere else. Maybe it's a ProtonMail account. Maybe it's owning your own domain. Whatever decision you make, let's make sure to make that decision only once, so that the next time you move or that the next time something happens, nobody will care that you now have a different email address, because you won't. You'll have the same email address no matter what. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/130592. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.